Like I said, there's another promenade right here. That's another main promenade through the park. And that goes along the water garden. We're seeing the last cell of the water garden here on your left. And then this is a real kind of critical moment where a lot of elements of the design and a lot of the challenges of the design come together, okay? So Pier 1, like I said, was landfill, right? So we can make a mountain on it and put big trees on it. In fact, the edge of Pier 1 was a pier. And you see the piles out there? In between, or right on that borderline, was a wooden sheet pile wall. So one of the things that we did in the design is before we did anything, because of design ideas, we did an engineering analysis of the site, especially in terms of the heavy infrastructure element. And the divers found that that wall was deteriorating, okay? So it's a big capital cost element, right? Wooden sheet cost, everybody knows what that is, right? So we were looking for opportunities to create natural environments here as well as horticultural environments. B, we wanted to make an incredible moment when you came in by the intimacy of the water garden, which of course you haven't experienced yet, and then get this big baboom moment over here where we peel, okay, and the Statue of Liberty behind. And also, we wanted to de-assess the future park operators of structure that we didn't think they really needed in terms of making a park, because it's expensive as hell to maintain the marine structures. So we ripped off that deck. But left the piles, and I like to call that my 70s earth art over there, okay? Unintentional. And then we carved the land back here instead of putting a new wall in, which is a vertical cantilever. So instead of doing that, which would again fail in another 50 years, we put in basically a permanent gravity-based solution by cutting it back and shaping it and putting rock on it, okay, riprap on it, and then instead of just making your standard riprap slope like you have anywhere, we created this earth terrace here and created the soil for a actual salt marsh. So this is Spartina growing here, the real native salt marsh in this briny water, and it seems to be doing well. And so we made a salt marsh in New York City. Isn't that kind of crazy? And one thing you'll see is a lot of floatables right here. That's the Army Corps Carlines, by the way, floatables. The floatables, ultimately there's a plan for the floatables that's not executed yet. Because really, one of the real groundbreaking ideas for the park is a recreational idea. It has to do with the water, okay? It's not a plant idea, but I'll tell you about it a little bit. Basically, we have a concept of making the water, 10 acres of water here, accessible to the general public in kayaks. And we do that by kind of transforming the nature of it a bit through engineering, okay? So what we do is we connect this basin you see here between Pier 1 and 2, and the next two basins between 2 and 3, and 3 and 5, by canals that aren't built yet. But we cut those piers off where that little car is parked. We cut a 60 foot wide canal there, and then through the next pier. And then connect the piers with those small bridges, okay? So you can kayak from this basin to the next basin, to the next basin. 10 acres of area, if you will, if you think about, you know, that becoming part of the park program, added to the park. And then to make that a little less hard for novices, we build wave attenuating structures that connect the points of the piers. And those are fixed like fence structures and floating structures so they keep the view open, okay? And they're essentially concrete, the floating ones are essentially concrete barges. And they have these fins that stick down and they quell the waves. From about a 3 foot wave is reduced to 6 inches. You get a lot of waves here from boats mostly. And so that could like swamp, you know, a kid in a kayak. And so, but also that then becomes the floatables barrier ultimately. So the floatables float away instead of getting stuck in the salt marsh, which is what they do now because that whole system is not done yet. So here, yes. Oh, yeah. I mean, I actually find the driftwood beautiful, you know? And the bottles, I've not come to appreciate yet, right? Dunkin' Donut cups, no. And there's no floatables. I know. Well, everybody in Battery Park City told us, get rid of your floatables because it costs us hundreds of thousands of dollars a year to get floatables out of nooks and crannies. And so that's why we did that. We're just, you know, following the advice of our elders. Yes.
We get that set every April. There's a group that does the country.